to the Godman Army. You can write us, P.O. Box 2500, Escondido, California, 92033, and get our new card. And in these cards, it shows you about the Qualcomm Stadium. Fill in the Qualcomm Stadium with 70,000 people praying. We put scriptures inside. It's a new card we created just for you, because we love you. And it says, and God is able to make all grace abound toward you, that you would always, I'm in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 9, having all sufficiency, and all things may have an abundance for every good work. He has dispersed abroad, he has given to the poor, his righteousness remains forever. Now he that supplies seed to the sower. So here again, God says he's going to supply seed to the sower. So you say, I can't read. Maybe you say, I can't read. Well, I'm here every Sunday, faithfully. How you doing, sister? Thank you for bringing the cookies. That was very sweet. So, remember, you have a voice channel. Today, we're talking about your image channel. We got to fix the image of how we see ourselves in the mirror, remember? We cut the TV on, it gives us images and voices. It gives us people playing role. They're acting. Well, then you need to act out the Bible. Amen? So every morning I get up, I say to myself, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. How many people know Psalms 23? Okay? Let's say that together. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Say that to yourself over and over. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Now we're talking about sowing the seed, watering it every day and every night, Joshua 1:8, chapter 1, verse 8, and producing a harvest. What is a harvest? A picture of Christ being there in our time of trouble. The Lord is our shepherd, we shall not want. So you may think, I'm in need, I'm hurting. No, the Lord is your shepherd, you shall not want. You say, how can that be, preacher? Well, God said. So the key is how to make it work. Right? I can buy you a $1,000 TV. This TV probably costs $1,000. Now look at this example. You say, oh my God, that stupid TV doesn't even work. I paid $1,000 for this TV and it doesn't even cut on. It ain't even cut on, does it? It looks like it's broke. But I can get that lady right there. She's the boss. I said, sister, cut the TV on, and boom, there goes somebody coming on TV and talking to us, right or wrong. Okay. Lady called me an idiot. She said, possible power button. But if I don't know, let's say I'm from Czechoslovakia. Say I'm from Afghanistan. Or from Timbuktu. I've never seen no TV. When I was in Africa, there's these little people called pygmies. They live in the woods. They're around 2 feet tall. They walk around like that. Yeah. I was in there digging for diamonds, and out comes these little people. I was, whoa, they're very sneaky. They live under the weed like that. They look at the butt of the weed. That's a person. Was a little man. He was only that tall. It's called pygmy. I never seen no pygmies before. Now, if I bring that pygmy man and sit him on that table and I say, now you cut that TV on for us, what is he gonna say? You know what I'm saying? Because he doesn't speak English. He never had no TV like that in the woods. You see what I'm getting at? And that's the same thing about the Bible. Until you learn to cut the Bible on, it will never work for you, mother. But when you learn to trim those channels, with the Bible, pretty soon the Bible comes alive. So in the pit, they stuck me in this pit for 60 months. So I said, I'm going to make lemonade out of lemons. I wasn't going to complain. He said I owed millions of dollars in taxes. I didn't know. Lord said, I'm trying to teach you something so you can seal the bleeding of your issues. See, really, God wanted to find me. But I didn't know that God wanted to find me. See, sometimes God will put us in particular places so we can see ourselves. Because most people don't want to look at themselves. Other people look at themselves in the mirror. They don't like themselves. I like myself. I like myself, Sam. I like brushing my teeth. I got to get a couple implants because I was giving all my money away and not taking care of my teeth. And you got to take care of your teeth or they'll just fall out. And then when you try to smile, what's going to happen? They're going to say, oh my God, that guy got rotten teeth in his mouth. I don't care how good you can preach if your smile isn't beautiful, right? So you got to take care of yourself. Some people eat. I was so fat, I was 280 pounds. So now, God said, I want you to fast 40 days in the pit now, in the pit. People stabbing each other, people fighting, chaos, prejudice, white people on this side, black people on this side, Mexicans on that side, Asians on that side, everybody's divided. And God said, I want you to see this.
Right.
Because I want you to see how people really are. How they really identify with each other. Because you can look at people, but you don't really know people until the real person comes out. Am I right or wrong? You can just, you know, they're surface friends. But then you push me the wrong way. I'm like, I don't like her. You see? That's deep seated down in me. Prejudice. Come on now. A lot of people, if you talk about their mother, they want to hit you. Oh. You got a mother, I got a mother. You got a father, I got a father. So we have to look at what we really are. So in the pit, I'm fasting, I'm praying, but God is trying to install the Bible in me. I thought I knew the Bible, mother, but it was in my head. It wasn't in my heart. You see the difference? A lot of people read the Bible, but it didn't get in their heart. So they don't really love God. They love God, but they can't love God. You see the difference? Like being married. If you was married, you could love the woman. I can love you, but that don't mean I'm in love with you. That don't mean if another pretty girl walked by, I'm not looking too, you see? Because my eye gates will follow what I love or what I'm interested in. And that's what happens with the Bible. So you really got to look at yourself. So in that pit, I began to look at myself, mother. Oh, I was crying all night. And God said, when do you want to stop crying and start winning some souls? Amen. You may be in here to win her soul. You may be in here to win her soul. You may be in here to win her soul. You may be in here to win her soul. Maybe she could die without Christ and go where? To hell. We are the greatest country in the world because we have Jesus Christ. We are the greatest country. Maybe you came here, mother, all the way from Iraq to know that Jesus loves you. We love you. If we don't get out of ourselves and start serving God.